This is just an introduction of mine. If you see, whenever you are performing an electroscopic surgery, there are three important components which you must know besides gradually increasing your curve in the practice of laparoscopic surgery. Number one is, and the foremost is, ergonomics, because surgery depends upon your port position, surgeon position, monitor position, so as to give you maximal comfort and maximal efficiency. You need to know about each and everything about the instrument, because here there is no touch sensation. It is all the sensations are being given to you or provided to you by the instruments we use, by the monitor or the camera which you use. And the third is the energy source. If you are performing any operative surgeries, you need to have a good knowledge regarding the energy source. So in this lecture series, I have focused myself in all these three components. So the learning objective of the current presentation is to tell you regarding the monitor position, how should be the operation theater table, surgeon's position, port positions. These are the basic four components, and many other things are there which you'll gradually learn or co-opt according to your surgeries. But these are the basic things. Before performing your surgery, you should be having a knowledge regarding these things. Taking one by one, what is this? Sit all the thing according to the surgeon's height before the surgery. Why I am telling you this? Because monitor position, OT table, might not be made according to the 5 feet 3 inch person. Majority of the females are not that tall. So we need to accommodate ourselves to these components. So how that has to be made, I'll tell you later on. So before performing the surgery, set all the things according to the surgeon's height. Okay. Hello everyone. In this lecture, I am going to tell you regarding the electrosurgery. And these principles are very important. Why it is very important? Because we are dependent upon OT technician, and our surgery is dependent upon the electrosurgery, especially the laparoscopic surgery. We say increase the wattage, increase to 30, increase to 40, it's not working, the instrument is not working. And sometimes after that we say, oh, on the third day the patient is having a distension and there is a bowel injury. So we don't know anything, and there is a lot of chaos. So you need to know, I have made this lecture series, that you need to know your instruments, you need to know your electrosurgery, and you need to know your ergonomics. Laparoscopy is all about ergonomics, instruments, and electrosurgery. Moreover, electrosurgery is the base which forms your, even base now these days forms the base of your open surgery also. So these lectures are going to help you out in the open surgery also, right? So coming to the principles of, right? Coming to the coagulation. Now, cutting was high frequency. Now, coagulation is low frequency, high voltage, modulated current with periods of activation and deactivation. Periods of activation and deactivation, and this helps in, this intermittent bursts of current help in heat dissipation in the tissue, which causes the protein degeneration, and then the coagulum is formed and the bleeding is controlled. There is a wide heating effect, considerable tissue damage, and more smoke production, right? So smoke production was there also, here also, but in cutting there was a less tissue damage and less heating effect as compared to coagulation waveform. In cutting there was an explosion due to the formation of the steam bubble, and here there is a protein denaturation and a coagulation.
So now just showing you a small video. I have shown you this is an insert, this is an inner sheath, and this is an outer sheath. It is very important because once you are cleaning the instrument, you clean it. Then all the parts are separate. Then you have to assemble it. And the assembly of this laprocator is very important because if you are not going to do it in a proper fashion, this instrument will not work. And there are many slits which have to come in one line, as I will show you. So these are the prongs. This I am going to do. First, you insert inner sheath in this, and you can see this is a slit, and this slit is matched with the upper part. So this is now being put here. Then we will insert from down, and we will push up, push up, push up, and this again has got a slit which will hinge here, right? So this will hinge here. Then we will adjust this ring collar device. So it is on the zero, then we have put over two, and then we tighten it and see whether the prongs are coming out easily or not, and they are pulling up or not. So this is all about the prostaglandins, and in the next lecture we will be taking further on the drugs used in OPS and gynae. So if you want to prepare your clinical viva, you can take a course on mechanism of labor, and where 5 video lectures are there. You can take a surgical instruments, 10 video lectures, and you can take a quick exam revision of table viva. It will be very beneficial if you take these three along with the long and short clinical cases, where 24 discussion are there, which will be helpful for all of you to prepare for the examination. Thank you.